Season 7 for the MCC has been released to the public, with amazing new features like the custom game browser and tweaks to the match composer and massively expanded customization. Wanted to cover everything that they added in to this season for the MCC, so stay tuned throughout the whole video to understand all the details. Now we have covered everything that's coming with Season 7 for the MCC, but they actually added in a couple extra goodies for us. So in this video, we'll cover some of the challenges, some of the new battle pass, and what kind of things you'll be unlocking within that, what the Mark 7 helmet from Halo Infinite looks like in MCC, and of course the custom game browser and much more. So if you guys like these news and informational kind of videos, make sure to tap that like button. Let me know if you want to see some more content like this. If you guys want to stay up to date with everything going on with Halo as it ramp up to the release of Halo Infinite, well, make sure you tap subscribe right there. Let's get right into the content. So when you boot into the MCC, you'll get this brand new splash screen. Again, just looks absolutely fantastic. Every new season has a new screen and it just looks amazing. So we've already covered a lot of the information that's going to be in the season, but it's going to be a brief overview. But I want to showcase you something brand new that just low-key 343 added into the game, and that is the extras tab. This extras tab has credits and you go, takes you right to this Halo support site as well, which is fantastic for reporting any bugs or issues that you have. But they have a new section called videos, which have all the terminals for CE, Halo 2 Anniversary, Halo 2 Anniversary cutscenes, as well as Halo 4 terminals as well. Because if you remember, the Halo channel no longer exists, which is where all this information was stored. Now it's in-game, you can just click on and watch all these amazing terminals. If you have not watched these guys, you really do. They really expand on the lore and the story of each game. I highly suggest checking them out. Now, I'm sure a lot of you are really interested in the new Halo Infinite helmet that's gonna be part of Halo 4, where you click on the exchange, and right here, the Keystone helmet is what it's called, and it's completely free. You had no season points required. You just click on it and go, hey, I like that helmet, let's unlock it. And well, now it's unlocked. And while we're at it, let's unlock the Light of Jewelry and the Gen 2 Burnt Ground Undersuit as well for Halo 3, because we can, it's the exchange. And we finally get our first look at the Battle Pass, Season Pass, whatever you want to call it, for Season 7, titled Elite. And this is where you're going to be unlocking a lot of your new armor sets for the season as well. As you can probably assume, it's titled Elite because most of the armor that's available in here is going to be the Elite armor. We do have the Champions bundle for Halo 4 locked away within this Battle Pass system as well. And 100 tiers of more awesomeness to unlock, with some more weapon skins for Halo 4, amazing sword customization for Halo 3, armor effects for Halo 4 as well within this Battle Pass, nameplates as you would expect, and the last item, tier 100, is the Eternal Blue Flame armor effect for Halo 4. And as we do every season, we get some new seasonal challenges. We have 12 new seasonal challenges to complete, guys. I will make a separate video breaking down exactly to do these seasonal challenges as well, so stay tuned to the channel. Make sure you subscribe to catch that video when it does go live. But we do have an energy sword skin that's tied away in the challenges. We do have a new tinted smoke tech suit for the challenges as well, and also the Pixel Perfect battle rifle skin for Halo 4. Now here's a quick example of the new sword customization and elite armor customization that's within Season 7. I posted this on my Twitter page and on my Instagram page, link in the description down below, guys, if you guys want to follow there. I just wanted to share these quick little shots for you guys, because a lot of the stuff you don't really truly get a chance to see how it looks like until it's in game. And man, does it look awesome. We also have a brand new map coming in for matchmaking for Halo 3, and that is the map Edge. We got a chance to test this out for Flighting for Season 6. Couldn't quite make the cut for performance wise, and so they had to delay the release of that map, but now it's coming in with Season 7, as well as Waterfall has gained some performance updates as well. As I do know, the people who play on Xbox One really struggle to maintain that 60 frames on that map, so hopefully your experience is quite a bit better. I've been playing on PC the whole time, so it plays well for me at least. We do have the Champions bundle coming in for Halo 4 customization as well, which brings four new armor sets. One is kind of a helmet, football helmet style one. Another one is an ODST style, a Forerunner style armor set, as well as the classic CE influenced armor set as well, coming into Halo 4. Again, all within the Battle Pass. I'm sure the update I'm sure a lot of you guys are really excited about is the custom game browser. So the way to find that, you go to multiplayer, custom game browser, and you go to either browse or create. If you want to create a match, you go to create, obviously, select Halo Reach, because Halo Reach is the only one that's available right now at the moment. But obviously you get to create your own lobbies, which is just so cool. But when you click on browse, this is what you come across on the Reddit. There are so many people. This update just went live like a couple hours ago, and there's already lobbies upon lobbies for custom game browser stuff to find, guys. So jump in and play this, guys, because it's a lot of fun. We will be doing a live stream tonight on the Twitch channel. You will 100% be playing around with this new custom game browser. And another really interesting surprise are mod tools within Halo Combat Evolved in the MCC. Stated here in the recent update, with this season we've released a couple of tools that players will be able to use for modding in Halo Combat Evolved. These mod tools are available to all PC players if you don't own MCC or Combat Evolved by default through your Steam Tools library. In your Steam library, simply select Tools from the drop-down menu and you'll see the mod tools in your collection by default. If you own MCC through Game Pass or Windows Store, you'll be able to access these tools through creation of a Steam account and utilizing the Steam desktop client, just as an MCC owner on Steam would do. If you're a longtime modder of Halo, some of these programs will look familiar in Guerrilla, Sapien, and Tool, but there is an additional tool called Standalone for some iterative testing of mods. I mean, that's such a huge feature that even SPV3, if you guys have played that mod, which is an incredible Combat Evolved mod, came out and just said this: with the release of the new MCC CE tools, we are announcing the end of the SPV project. We will have one update to issue, which will have some more firefight maps, as well as a launcher and installer update. But new projects are already underway for MCC. More details to come. So that's how significant this update for mods for CE is. That looks like Custom Edition is going to be kind of left in the dust and people are going to be modding the MCC version, which is going to be incredible to see what people create over the next few months or so for CE. Mod tools and the modding community is what's going to keep MCC alive and people returning to the MCC even after the launch of Halo Infinite. This is an absolutely massive addition. If anything great comes from mods, I guarantee I'll share on this channel, guys. And talking about Combat Evolved while we're at it, it also received a massive graphical update, guys. The bump mapping and the visuals are much more true to the original Xbox version of Combat Evolved than ever before. Because if you don't know, the Gearbox version, which we do play on the MCC, is a bit busted for the visuals, or at least was now. As you can see, the classic mode graphics in MCC and the original CE graphics right here, you can see a clear comparison between the two were not exactly the same. Now, after the MCC flight and what I played, it's definitely much more in line with the images on the right, which are true to the original graphics of Combat Evolved as well. Firefight also received a massive update as well, as it now is part of the match composer. So when you click on matchmaking for Firefight, you get these options. So now you can mix and match your Halo 3 ODST and Halo Reach experiences as well. They do mention the reason why they did this change is so then they can possibly add in some new timed events or a special playlist that they could throw in on top of the original set of maps and modes and stuff like that we do receive right now. And within this, you can just quickly just swap over to match made games that you would normally come across within the MCC, or if you want to go to Firefight, there you go as well. So an absolutely massive new update for the MCC, guys. I also will be releasing a how to rank up fast video very soon, as well as a challenge guide as well for the MCC for season 7. So make sure you subscribe to the channel to catch those videos when they do go live. So thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it. If you've been on the loop for Halo for the last few days or so, or missed any content from me recently, check out the videos on the screen right here. I've got a link to all my news and informational videos. Thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it. And I'll catch you on the next one. Peace out.